everything that we do is governed by the muscle test. We are looking for why someone is ill, why they have symptoms. And it can be pathogen. It can be allergy to electromagnetic frequency. It can be plain old allergy or the body's fighting itself. There's a host of reasons that people's bodies get undermined. And one of those reasons may be, if the muscle test approves, spiritual reasons. Now, when you say spiritual, where I go with that is Einstein, who said there is no matter, everything is energy. If the energy goes faster than the speed of light, well, then you're into the interdimensional realm where quantum physics lives, which the religious people call realm of the spirit or the spiritual. So you can have things that your body is not responding to properly that come from areas that we cannot see with our eyes because it's just going faster than the speed of light. What's cool is that the muscle test, the body's vision, is able to see what these things are. And during the spiritual, we point them out, and then people get greater guidance from their own bodies on things to do that they never would have thought of that would support and shore up their bodies in a significant way to reduce symptoms. The awareness is key. The awareness is key. If you become aware that eating out of aluminum pans is poisoning your body, you may then choose not to eat out of aluminum pans and avoid dementia, okay? So awareness for a human being so they can make the right choices often is key to doing things that will support their health and avoiding things that will take away their health. What separates ACT from other alternative modalities is we have a key question that any evaluation will revolve around, which is, what is the body doing wrong? What is the immune system doing wrong? Many other modalities are looking at what product do you need, what machine do you need, what do you need to eat, what do you need to avoid to eat. We're not looking at that. We're looking at what is the body doing wrong. And it's a totally new paradigm for many, many people because they don't have the tool that ACT gives, which is a way to get a human being to change the way the body responds to things. So, to go through a couple of examples, if someone has a pathogenic disease, it's because the pathogen are being allowed to live through the misbehaviors of the body. People don't think that way. You mean my body could kill those pathogen if it performed differently? Absolutely. Absolutely. If the immune system performs properly, no pathogen can remain in your body. None. It can kill anything. So that means that if something is living in you, Bartonella, worms, parasites, candida, mold, fungus, yeast, bacteria, viruses, it's because the body isn't addressing it properly. The immune system's got the gun, but it's not pulling the trigger. So what this tool of advanced cell training is a way to get the body to pull the trigger. So and once the body learns how to shoot and fend for itself, not only do the pathogen not have a chance to remain, but that body remembers that pathogen for the rest of its life. So if you're re-exposed to the same virus 10 years later, the body's got the gun. So that is a very, very different way of looking at it. What most practitioners are going to look at is, what setting on the Rife machine do you need? What antibiotic do you need? What parasite cleanse do you need? All of that goes away if the immune system can be activated properly. Same thing for allergies. For allergies, it's pills, it's avoidance. If the body stops overreacting to the allergen, the symptom goes away. You don't need all of that. So what is the body doing wrong is the core thing that we look at for every symptom, because you've now got a way with ACT to get your body to do it right. It's a game changer. The reason this is hard to believe is because all of your programming through television, commercials, movies, is that they're going to do something to your body and they're going to make you well. They will do everything that they do in the hopes that the body will take over. What we've done is just taken a look at, you know, what you were alluding to, is that my body's able to get rid of, to reject a screw that was surgically implanted through its way of behaving. Why can't it kill pathogen? Well, it can, but what we're up against here is a cultural lie. You know, somebody said that if you repeat the same lie over and over again, it becomes other people's truths. The truth of the matter is the human body can heal itself if it behaves properly. That's not being sold anywhere. There's no annuity in that. Part of the advanced self process is to shake off the cultural lie that the body cannot heal itself, because now we have a process to change its behavior so that it can do the very foundational things in the right way. Your body didn't want that screw in your leg. It got rid of it. When your body wakes up and realizes that there are pathogens there, it can get rid of them. If you're fighting allergies, it can stop doing that. If your body is attacking itself through autoimmune, it can start to support and protect itself and regenerate itself. This is all about behavior, and it is acknowledged by the communities, but they're into giving crutches, and hopefully the body does heal itself. This is far more direct. Emotions are why we are here. It is our foundation for being. We are here to learn how to love. So when we are betrayed, we go into hate, anger, depression, vengeance, which of course is not love, and really upsets the body's system. So a lot of people will ask me, well, why do, once they understand how powerful it is to get their body to behave properly, start killing pathogen and all of that, and they get better, they will ask, well, why did my body start to misbehave in the first place? The most powerful hit a person can take often is an emotional hit. It so disrupts the body that it will begin the process of misbehavior toward things. So that's a foundation. Our foundation is emotion. Now, it's not true for everybody. Some people can go through tremendous betrayals and their bodies just perform properly and they don't get sick other than they're miserable emotionally. Other people like me, every time I got angry, my back would go out. So we're all different, but generally it's emotion that begins the misbehavior process, and that can even come through you from your ancestors generationally. They may have some thing that happened to them and their body started to fight ragweed, and so you're born and your body's fighting ragweed and you had great parents. The reach of emotional betrayal can manifest physically and can be very foundational to health and must be addressed. And thankfully, the body can address it. So. Chronic illness is chronic because the person hasn't yet stumbled upon the right answer to correct that. So let's say you've got a screw that needs to be tightened, and the people that you're seeing only have a wrench. You're gonna have a chronically loose screw because they don't have a screwdriver. They only have a wrench. The problem is when people then believe that the person with the wrench is the only game in town. That isn't true. It took me 35 years to even look at alternative medicine. And that's when I found my screwdrivers, okay? So I was sick for 35 years. I could have believed that the people I was seeing was the only game in town. Had I done that, I would have kept doing the same things that were not working, and I would have remained ill. When I started looking at people with other tools, I found other tools that actually worked, and today I'm not ill anymore. So part of chronic illness has to do with the available tools to the people you rely upon to help you heal.
Thank you for watching. If you found this video interesting, please click the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time we release a new video.